land is just basically a symbol of workplace of the organization. It could be a cloud itself. Hello everyone, welcome to Plutus IS. I am CA Sonali Jindal. Today we will try to understand the GS economy syllabus through one single diagram, because UPSC has not given direct in clear words what it needs to be covered in the GS economy. You must have seen the syllabus of prelims where very broader terms has been given. One is economic and social development, inclusion, sustainable development. So clear syllabus has been not given by the UPSC. Now we will try to understand through one single diagram why you need to cover particular topics in the economy. So you must have heard about the factors of production. We are starting our video through the factors of production. Now you have to think about one entrepreneur. Maybe I am taking the example of Ratan Tata ji. Some innovative idea has come to his mind, like he will open one factory. Now you should know, if one factory has been opened, there is a need of entrepreneur like Ratan Tata. Obviously, for opening the factory he also needs the money. Ratan Tata ji is a rich man and wealthy. He can open his factory with his own money. But think about the small entrepreneurs, small businesses. Maybe they could need some loan. Loan could be taken from the banks or any financial institution. It could be from NBFCs. Maybe he could invest in some shares, debentures. He could use his own small savings. So for opening a basically factory, there is a need of some savings. Maybe he could take the loan from banks. Thereafter, for opening a factory, he needs a land. Sorry, I am taking the example of factory. It could be any institution. You can take example of Plutus IS. Obviously, for that also, there was need of land so that institution can be opened. So first factor of production is entrepreneur, like Ratan Tata ji. Then comes the money. Money can be taken from banks, and there is next factor of production is land. Now you can understand, in land, for after opening a factory, there is a need of labor to work upon it. Only an entrepreneur can't work. In fact, even in the Plutus IS Academy, you can see there are numerous faculties, editing team, admin staff. There is a need of some labor so that they can work. Even in the agriculture, there is a need of labor for the harvesting, tilling. So whatever the sector of economy is, maybe agriculture, maybe industries, maybe services sector, all needs are labor. So you can understand all the factors of production from there, from here. Now we have seen the factors of production. Now you should understand, there is a cost on every factor of production. If you are taking a land, maybe you can be buying it. For buying the land, there is a need of some money. So you are paying that. Then maybe you are landing this land. So here you are paying the rent. In the new era, if we see, there are e-commerce businesses. So it could be alternative of land. So land is just basically a symbol of workplace of the organization. It could be a cloud itself. Cloud is also a new land for the new businesses. Here the land is only a metaphor. You have to think broader. Then the labor. Here the wages are being paid, or the salaries are being paid to the labor. It is the cost on the labor. On the capital, obviously if it's your savings, imagine Ratan Tata ji using his own savings to invest. Take an example. For example, he is having a 1 lakh. He has two options. Imagining a person has having 1 lakh, he has two options. One is he could make a deposit in a bank. He might be earning 6% on it. The other option available to that person is to make a investment in a business. So even if it's your own savings, there also a cost. What is the cost? It is called as opportunity cost. Because obviously he will think, now if he would have not invested in the business, he might have earned the 6% per annum. So there is an opportunity cost on the capital. If you have taken the loan from the bank, then there is an interest cost. You have to pay the interest on the bank. Obviously, bank will not give you money for the free. Then the entrepreneurship, what is the cost on it? Profit has to be paid to the entrepreneur. If we are taking the management and the business, basically, management ownership is considered to be separate. That's why the entrepreneurship takes the profit out of it. Now, think about the different capital in the new era. It could be from the bank, NBFCs, venture capital. You can think of it, and we will see this in detail later. One other thing, maybe you could be getting the subsidy from the government. Maybe you are getting the FDI from the external sector. That's why we are reading about these concepts in our syllabus, because there is a need of the capital in the business or any economy. Then comes the stock market. So you might be raising the funds from the public. Now comes the circular flow of income between two sectors only. Same factor payments need to be paid. Now, households consider them as a labor, or maybe your landowners from whom you have taken the land on the rent. These firms need to pay them factor payments. Here, households might be providing the labor services, land services, different services are being provided by the households. Then the firms need to pay for these payment goods and services. Payment needs to be paid for the goods and services by the households, because firms also provide the goods and services. You have understood the simple diagram. Now we will include the government into this. Households pay the taxes to the government, and businesses also pay the taxes to the government. In return, government provides you different services like road services. It also provides the subsidies. For this, government makes a budget. That's why you read about the budget, and here comes the fiscal policy. It is called as the fiscal policy, where the government makes the arrangement for the taxes and subsidies. And businesses is paying to the government different taxes. You have heard about the GST. That's why the question can be asked on the GST or the income tax. Now we will include the different institutions into the same diagram. A household will make the savings into the financial institution. That savings will be used by the bank to give to the loan. Now you have to think. If a person saves around 1 lakh, instead of making the deposit in the banks, he might be investing in the gold. Or maybe he is keeping his money as a cash in his locker only. Can that be converted into the investment? Can that be given as a loan to the firms? That's why government focuses on the sovereign gold bonds, so that money can be used to lend further to the businesses. Because you have already seen, businesses don't keep that money with themselves. They keep paying back to the households as a factor payments, maybe as a rent or maybe as a wages. to create that investment, there is a need of focus on the savings. That's why the question has been asked, why the saving is the most important factor in the potential GDP. From here, the basic diagram the UPSC has asked the question in the mains. Then, if we include the rest of world into the same diagram, like exports has been done by the firms to the rest of the world and the imports has been done, FDI comes into the India, here the comes the external sector. That's why you read about the FDI, about the import and exports in the balance of payments. We will see the balance of payment in detail later, but at least see that why you need to cover this. Now you can see the syllabus. Try to apply the same diagram to see that syllabus. National income is what is it? It is GDP, the goods and services produced by the firms. It is considered as a national income. Inflation, if there is a high demand for the goods and services, then basically inflation is being considered because the prices is being increased due to the demand. You can apply the same to this diagram. Firms get the loan from the banks on which rate it will get the loan. It is considered by the monetary policy. Monetary policy is basically a concept where the RBI decides how it will regulate the inflation by controlling the money supply. Obviously, you can understand if there is a huge money with your hand, ek tendency hoti hai na, if we get the whole huge money, we will try to spend more. So if you will spend more, there will be a more demand in the economy. If there is a more demand, then the prices will increase. Then this relation comes with the inflation. Why? That's why you have to read about the inflation concept so that you can decide about the monetary policy. A fiscal policy, we have seen with the government. Now, inflation you have seen, monetary policy we have seen in that diagram. Then the fiscal policy, government budgeting, we have seen the arrangement made by the government between the taxes and subsidies and about the loan. It is being considered in the fiscal policy. Planning, it is directly given in the main syllabus. Taxation policy is considered to be in the fiscal policy. External sector we have seen. Financial markets, why you need to consider it? Because these are the options of capital. It could be basically stock market, it could be banking sector, it could be insurance sector. Then the Indian economy, evolution and industrial growth, it is considered in main syllabus. It is directly given in the main syllabus. Agriculture, industrial growth, because you need to read about the different firms that is in the sectors of economy. What are the different firms? It could be primary sector, secondary sector and the tertiary sector. Infrastructure and investment models, it is directly given in the main syllabus. So we will make a diagram by ourselves to show every topic on it so that you can revise what we have discussed in this video. Households and firms. So here we will read about the different terms. It could be agriculture, industries and services sector. We will see what are the growth factors in these firms and the households. These will make a basically deposit savings in the financial, any of the financial institution. Then it will further lend. Here you will read about the RBI monetary policy. Now, firms will provide the goods and services. To calculate this, why we read the national income? It will pay for the goods and services. Households will provide the basically factor services. and in return it will pay to it. There comes the government. It will pay the taxes and it will provide the subsidies. Similar relation with the firms. Here comes the fiscal policy. Then we will include the external sector. It might be lending to the firms as a FDI, or maybe external commercial borrowings is being made by the firms. Then it also imports. All this is being read in the balance of payment. External sector, there is also need to read about the international financial institutions like WTO, World Trade Organizations, then World Bank and IMF. Here you can see, read about the inflation. Now from this diagram, you should prepare this diagram from yourself so that you can write your answers holistically and with understanding, because obviously examiner get to know whether you have understood that topic or not, and try to build this diagram so that the syllabus will be ingrained in your mind. Thank you.